Shabbat shalom, H cuties. It is Friday night. The feeling is right. And it has finally come to pass. The eighth and final night of Passover is here. Not eight crazy nights, not like Hanukkah, but at this point of the holiday, I'm about 70% matzah meal, little stuffed up. But by sundown tomorrow, it's back to all the bagels and pasta and donuts and muffins and brownies and cookies and cupcakes and pancakes and challah French toast my heart desires. But you don't have to wait for any bread. You could be making dough tonight, right here, right now on HQ, the live mobile game show where you answer questions to win cash. I am your host, who eats matzah pizza, your guy with the matzah braai, Pesach Rocky, young Elijah, Kendrick Maror, Scott Rogowsky, noshing on farful by the jarful from the greatest city on earth, the city that never sleeps, Gadsden, Alabama, parting the Red Sea with all 985,000 of you live right now around the world, including Kim's daughter, Kate, Amy Kritzer, Juliana Neflin, celebrating a birthday, Alejandro in España, Feliz Cumpleaños, Brittany Hudgens, Boney Starks, Chris's brother Wayne, Carl DeLow, Ariana, Kayla, Sam, Lisa, Sarah, and Allie. There's no wandering the desert for 40 years here. No, just navigating the promised land. Answer all 12, you could win. Cold, hard cash, I'm talking 5,000 Dave Winfields, 5,000 Dwayne Wards, $5,000. You know you can do with that kind of money? You could afford a really nice bike or a really mediocre car. Have you felt passed over when it comes to winning HQ? Do you feel enslaved to the trivia taskmasters? Have you been pining to escape from the savagery to see your name and avatar in the winner's circle on the leaderboard? Well, tonight I say, let my HQties go. Follow me. Follow me to freedom. Let's get down to the nitty-gritty. With 1 million plus players, a milli, let's get this show on the road for Cumero numero uno. What is applied to unpopped corn to pop it? Peer pressure, heat, or nail polish? Pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. If you can build up enough peer pressure, some insecure kernels might be susceptible to combustion. But then again, no. Heat, aka height. High temperatures, not the 1995 Michael Mann, De Niro, Pacino, Kilmer movie, can always be counted on to pop 90 to 95% of your corn. There's always a few who avoid their fate there. 1,014,598 have a destiny to win HQ tonight. Q2, what advice would you most likely get from an orthodontist? Dye your hair, finish that screenplay, or floss regularly? Your orthodontist is very concerned about your dental health. Therefore, flossing is important, and your orthodontist will remind you to do that. Floss regularly, whether you have braces or not. All that being said, you really should finish that screenplay. 999.82, surviving Q2, getting Q3, tartar control people. Which of these names also refers specifically to a male duck? Meek, Mill, or Drake? A male duck. She say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love fully sexually mature adult male ducks. I'm sorry. Drakes are male ducks. If you're not an ornithologist, maybe the Drake's Cakes logo gave it away? Take a look at the box next time you unwrap a ring ding. Ooh, looky here. We lost over 364,000 to Meek and Mill. Meek Mill? No, 615,119. Free Schmo. You got a really big team. The rest of you, running through the six with your woes tonight. We got Q4. Which magazine is known for its annual ranking of the 400 wealthiest Americans? Financial Times, Fortune, or Forbes? That's why I need a one dance. That's why I need a Q4. Financial Times at Ridgemont High ranks business schools. Fortune has the Fortune 500 listing the wealthiest corporations. But the Forbes 400 ranks Americans by net worth every autumn. 461,322 are on the HQ list tonight. Would you believe this? 88% of the Forbes 400? Old white guys. Huh. Q5. Which of the five main human senses primarily relies on papillae? Taste, sight, or hearing? Papillae. Papili, Papalu, Papardo. Here's some tasty trivia for you. Papillae is the medical term for taste buds. It's important to have taste buds, but it's more important to have buds with taste. 360,236 are getting this one right. You guys can take what I gave. You're getting a taste of Q6, the rest of you down and getting dragged along and around. Out. Q6, which U.S. state has a capital city with an American Indian name? Arizona, Florida, or North Dakota? We had over 1 million to start at the halfway point. We have chiseled that down by more than half. We're at 360,000 in the game still. Phoenix, Arizona, named for a mythical bird. And Bismarck, North Dakota, named for the old Prussian statesman Otto von Bismarck. But Tally, T-Town, Tallahassee, Tallahassee, Florida, is thought to be a Creek word meaning old town. 124,765. Tomachalk chopping on to Q7, although we did lose a whole lot of you there. Shout out Warwick Dunn and Charlie Ward, FSU. Q7, which of these common food additives comes from the ocean? Guar gum, carrageenan, or pectin? That's not the band guar. That's not like chewing gum from that band guar. Guar gum, carrageenan, pectin. All three are thickening agents. Looking thick tonight, but guar gum comes from the guar bean grown on land. The other two are derived from cellulose, but pectin is naturally occurring in land plants, berries, fruits, whereas carrageenan is extracted from seaweed. 68,172 gonna be swimming on tonight. We did weed out, close to 60K right there. Ouchie, wowie. Q8, to Londoners, the board game Americans know as Clue is known as what? Clue who, Clue time, or Cluedo? Clue. Was it Colonel Mustard in the kitchen with the vape pen? The game we Yankees know as Clue was invented in jolly old England. To crack this case of whodunit, you need to know that the name of this game was inspired by a Parcheesi-like game called Ludo. Clue plus Ludo equals Cluedo. Cluedo Nash is your answer here, 30,307. Solve the case at Q8. The rest of you hate this question so much that flames burning, side of my head, breathing heavy. Q9. Eggs Benedict made with crab meat instead of ham is commonly known as what? Eggs Juno, Eggs Poseidon, or Eggs Neptune? Shout to Madeline Kahn. Rest in peace. You were the best. You're going to feel pretty crabby if you made it this far on HQ tonight, only to lose on a brunch question. You might see this dish on a menu as Crab Benedict, but we prefer to call it by its Christian name, Eggs Neptune, named after the god and the planet, who's named after the god also. 18,599, named that Neptune tonight. You're extremely excited for Q10. I can go on making egg puns all Holland days. Q10, the name of the famous satellite Sputnik roughly translates to what? Skywalker, view tomorrow, or travel companion? You know, $5,000 could buy Eggs Neptune for you and all of Pawtucket. The Rusky successfully launched Sputnik into the heavens in 1957, 20 years too soon for a Star Wars tie-in. It's not Skywalker. It's ironic because Sputnik was an unmanned, all alone on its journey to space. Could have used a travel companion, don't you think? Travel companion's your answer, 7,007. Getting this one right, just relax, you're doing fine. You can bring a companion on this ride to Q11. Ransom Riggs' debut novel was adapted into a movie by what director? Richard Linklater, Tim Burton, or Guillermo del Toro? Ransom Riggs. Well, it wasn't adapted into the movie Ransom with Mel Gibson, no. Ransom Riggs. Rack 'em, Rack Ransom Riggs published Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children in 2011. 5 years later, Mr. Nightmare Before Christmas, Tim Burton, directed the movie adaptation 3,104. Getting this right, the rest of you left on the cutting room floor. You came so close, but no e-cig. 3,104 HQDs are left tonight on this Friday night. We started with over 1 million. We're down to 3,104 for the final round. This is it, folks. It all boils down to this. $5,000 on the line. Who's going to be paying for brunch tomorrow with those eggs, Neptune? Q12, a son of Rutherford B. Hayes, co-founded a company that invented what household item? Brillo pad, vacuum cleaner, or D battery? And you see, sons of presidents aren't all screw-ups. Rutherford. Burchard Hayes. Rutherford the Brave. The 19th president of the United States had 8 children, 2 of whom have their own Wikipedia page. And the relevant son for this question is Mr. Webb Hayes, who was a co-founder of the National Carbon Company, which in 1898 introduced the first D-cell battery. D batteries are answer. Savage Q12, 366 are our winners tonight, baby! Throw some D's on that. Just bought a Cadillac. Throw some D's on that. 366. Okay, so it's not enough to buy a Cadillac, but you won HQ. Remember, that's glory and gloating rights for the rest of your life. You did it. You made it to the mountaintop. You split $5,000 366 ways, which is $1,367. Some of you get a penny less. I apologize for that, truly. Venmo me for that extra penny. Alex TLSS making some money move tonight. Jobo 137, Jobo, nice shades. Phil's Bistro, snowman, sandman thing, cool. Cool avatar, dude. That's our game tonight, folks. Tip your waitstaff, exit through the side doors. Come back mañana, tomorrow night, that's right. 9 p.m. and don't forget Sunday, $25,000. Never miss a Sunday show. Never miss a Sunday show. It's the freaking weekend, baby. Go out, have yourself some fun. I'm off till Monday, but until then, this is Scott Rogowsky signing off saying, next year in Jerusalem. Bye!